Hi, my name is Monique Dang, and I am a graduate student clinician here at the University of Illinois Audiology and Speech Pathology Clinic. Today, I am going to discuss communication repair strategies. Now, sometimes there can be a breakdown in communication, which can create a frustrating and embarrassing situation for someone with a hearing loss. So my goal for today is to just provide you with a few repair strategies so that you and your communication partners can get that conversation back on track when there is a breakdown. My first strategy for you today is to make sure that your partner is facing you. Sometimes we need to rely on visual cues and speech reading in addition to our hearing. Breakdowns in communication may occur when you are simply unable to see your partner's face when they're speaking to you. With that being said, kindly remind your partner to face you when speaking and to make sure that their mouth is unobstructed so that you do have access to those visual cues. And as the communication partner, try to be conscious of your surroundings. So that's making sure that you aren't trying to speak from a different room and that the room that you are in has good lighting, again, so that your partner has access to those visual cues. And then just like lastly, make sure that you're getting your partner's attention first before you're trying to speak to them. My second strategy for you is repetition and repeating or rephrasing. Tell your partner the parts of the message you understood and ask them to either repeat or rephrase the parts that you didn't catch. And asking your partner to rephrase something can be particularly beneficial as some words may be more difficult for you to understand than others simply due to their pitch. The third strategy is to spell it out. There may be a few words in a particular conversation that is important and therefore can't necessarily be rephrased. An instance of this may be when you are making plans with your communication partner to meet at a restaurant at a later time. So you can do this by simply asking, "Can you spell the name of the restaurant out?" This is a strategy that can prevent any misunderstandings in communication, and it's especially so when it's something that's as important as meeting someone at the correct location. Now, my last strategy for you is to have your communication partner cue you in when the topic of conversation has changed. This is especially important and very, very useful when you are in a group situation. It's much, much easier for us to follow a conversation and infer what's being said when we have the context and background knowledge of the topic at hand. I hope that you find some of these communication repair strategies to be useful. Communication breakdowns can be embarrassing and frustrating at times, but it's important to be proactive and have these conversations with your communication partners and loved ones, so that you know what works best for you when communicating and you have that transparency about what your communication needs are.